And so we begin. Oh. Move that out of the way. There we go. Everything is ready, chat. So, let me think. I'm not sure what I want to do here. I don't want to go right into Gym Leader Castle, but we have a good amount of time, so I think we should do a stadium today. But the question is, which one do we do? Because there's four different ones we need to do. Two of which we need to do four times over. So we have Poke Cup, Challenge Cup, Little Cup, and Prime Cup. So ultimately, it doesn't matter which one we do. We have to do them all anyway, but which one should we get out of the way first? Why do you need them four times? Because there's four different cups within the cup itself. There's 10 stadiums you have to do. Challenge, because it's dumb. The thing about Challenge Cup is it's already a randomizer. Hold on, let me get the music up a bit more. Okay. I wonder how Challenge Cup works with that. Randomizer. Alright. Let's give it a shot, I suppose. I'm really annoyed the Challenge Cup is the one that you have to do four of. Pokemon I caught in the mountains and forests are tough. Alright, what did they give me, game? What did the game give me? Oh, I see. So I have, Hop Pip. I have Ditto. I have Slow Poke. I have Geodude, I have Charmander, and I have Spinarak. He's got the MVP Diglett though. So everything's level 30. Hoppip has Headbutt, Toxic, Solar Beam, and Poison Powder. Ditto has Transform. That's good. Hoppip has a Miracle Seed. You have Water Gun, Sunny Day, Psychic, and Dig. That's incredible. You have Psychic, String Shot, Sludge Bomb, and Swagger. That's also incredible. You have Rock Throw and Dig, that's kind of shitty. And you have Dig and Fire, that's really good. Okay, chat, we have enough ground coverage here that we don't even need to bring Geodude, which is great. So let's see, we have an Ice type. So we have Fire types and Ground types. So, Fire types and Ground types. And I guess technically Ice. So definitely Slowpoke. Definitely Slowpoke. Slowpoke cleans up super hard. Geodude, the problem is, I have access to Dig, but they definitely all have access to Earthquake and shit like that, right? So if I get Earthquaked while I'm using Dig, I'm fucked. So I gotta be careful about that. So, I guess, I don't know. Who's the best one to use here? The thing is, I could use Charmander or Geodude. Geodude will get more stab out of it. But Charmander, wait, chat, if you use is Earthquake a guaranteed hit on a Pokemon underground? Like is that guaranteed? Can you not avoid it? Cause I've never seen that situation before. You cannot avoid it? So double team Dig won't work. Shit. I know it does double damage, yeah. Magnitude and Earthquake do double damage to opponents and Dig. Spinarak is not a good idea. Pretty much gets shit on by everything. Rocks and ground alike. Hoppip's okay, but doesn't do too well against two of the Pokemon. Three Pokemon, so it's kind of a gamble. But it's a gamble I think it's worth taking. And I guess we'll go with Geodude just in case. Because Ditto won't help, because none of these Pokemon do well against each other anyway. Well, no, that's not true. If I copied Diglett and had Earthquake, Diglett could clean up itself, but it probably won't, and it's not worth risking that on one Pokemon. Too many scenarios to consider, and I'm already going to get hit by the Diglett anyway to transform. So let's just go with that. Oh boy. Slowpoke. Does Bulldoze have the same effect as Dig? It does not, I don't believe. No, it doesn't. I know why it doesn't, because I watched a white 2-speed run, And Excadrill used Dig, and it avoided Bulldoze. So, wait, what am I staring at? Larvitar. Larvitar's Rock Ground, so it dies pretty much instantly to Water Gun. But I don't go first. Here's the first move. It withstood that easily. Just don't get flinched. You ever just talk? How annoying. What a great start. Alright. That should kill it, honestly. That didn't kill it. I kind of wish I had Surf, not Water Gun. Screech. Why do you have Leer and Screech? Ow! Alright, well my Slowpoke's gonna fucking explode. Okay, here's the shimmy jimmy, chat. I'm going to switch Slowpoke out even if it's advantageous matchup because I'm not going first and my defense is now -3. That's dangerous. It's too dangerous to stay in, so I'm gonna switch. This is a good opportunity to go to Geodude, actually. I think the way stadiums work is you get continues if you beat someone without losing a Pokemon. But I'm not doing that. I can try. But I'll probably save state just to be safe because for those of you that know anything about Pokemon Stadium, you know that you have Dragon Rage. No, that's broken. That's absolutely broken. Pokemon Stadium 2, or Pokemon Stadium in general, gives you multiple tries, but if you game over, you go back to Trainer 1 of 8 trainers. That's painful. And in a game like Pokemon, you don't really want to fuck around with that. Alright, nail him. This should be enough to kill it. Good. Alright, what's next? I hope it's Diglett. If it's Diglett, I'm switching into Hoppip, and we're good. I'm switching to Hoppip anyway, just to see. Let's take a look. If he uses Dig, I get a free Solar Beam. Slowpoke is fine. Probably, but I'd rather not risk it. If it has a ground type move, it used that anyway. If it has a rock type move, it'd be stupid to use it. Sunny day. Chat, do you see my brain right now? Of course you don't, because I don't have a webcam. My brain is like extended to the other side of the room. It's that big. It's that big. Do you see how I just predicted that? I'm a genius. My brain is the fucking universe. I had a brain blast. That Solar Beam is a one turn move and I win. And that was the most free Solar Beam of my career! Wow, Hoppip cleaned up. Perfect, actually. Yeah, so you get an extra continue if you get a perfect. A shutout. Should I go look for stronger Pokemon? You should just become a better trainer, dog. Okay, that's one. So hold on. So yeah, just... Current save state. Save set 1. So just to get out of the way, chat, I am going to make save states just in case things go wrong. I won't load them unless it absolutely, like, is pretty much about to boot me out. Because, you know, I don't want to do every single fight over again. But they're just in safety's sake, so we don't repeat the same thing over and over and over and over again. Because this isn't exactly a challenge run by me. I'm just trying to play the game and get to the end. I won't care if anything happens to your Pokemon. He has a bunch of poison types. Poison and grass types. Safety. Yeah, basically. So, I have best bet for this. If I'm looking at this correctly, they're all poison types. So, Slowpoke is automatically the best choice. Geodude and Charmander, very, very easy choice. Very, very easy choice. It's a run of the Challenge Cup, though. Shut up! Shut up, bro. Kick your ass. Alright, so everything's weak to Psychic. The only issue is Bellsprout. Alright. Psychic should be enough. Hey, it's gonna go first, though, of course. Wait, why is this thing's name Iggly Bask? Isn't that supposed to be an Igglybuff's name? That'll probably kill it. Wound down. Blithering Fool! How did a Rocket Grunt get in here anyway? Then again, I say that, but Team Rocket entered like every single contest. So the reason that he switched to Zubat is because Zubat probably has Leech Life or Absorb. If he brought... or Giga... oh, okay. Yeah, Giga Drain. I was gonna say, the AI will select... oh, fuck off. The AI will select a Pokemon that can deal with your immediate Pokemon in front of you. Since he didn't send out Bellsprout, it means he does not have Bellsprout. Of course, this is all just speculation on my part, but it seems to be correct. So that sucks a bit, but if that's the worst he's got, then whatever he sends out next is probably easy pickings for Slowpoke, and I don't even need to worry about anything. Yeah. Nidoran Male, Double Kick or Poison Sting? Oh, yeah, okay. You... I wasn't expecting that. Is that enough? Nice. Cleaned up. Blithering Fool! Look at Slowpoke. Who doesn't love Slowpoke? Chat, I got a question for you. What do you like more, Slowbro or Slowking? What? This is bad news. And there's the Hive badge. That's heat? That's Sheer Force Nidoking, dog. What do you mean that's heat? Continue. Slowking for the rule on its anime and movies. I agree to that. Slowbro's a really good Pokemon, though. It feels wonderful to battle Pokemon outside. I could use pants. You have a Larvitar too. Mega Slowbro is one of my favorite mons because he's funny. Spin Top Boy. With fucking crit resistance too, so he's some shit, alright. Alright, so we have grass. So common theme here seems to be flying types. We have Larvitar and Seal. So best choice is probably to lead with Geodude. I think leading with Geodude is a good choice. And then Charmander and Slowpoke. Yeah. Yeah, I think I like that. Seal can fly. So speaking of Seals chat, I am currently on volume 7 of Wildhorn Hermit now. And yeah, I really like it. I really, really, really like it. I really do. Oh, you're switching? You what now? I don't have Earthquake for that. Wait, if a flying type uses... chat, if a flying type uses Dig and you use Earthquake, do they get hit by it? This is an important question. Then do shit. What do you think of Rain Moon portrayed in Wildhorn Hermit? Greedy. She's very greedy. The fact that she decided to run a whole, like, Ponzi scheme on the side for fortune telling... she's very greedy. It's not that I'm not used to it, but I do. That's probably one of the few complaints I'll have about it, is that I don't mind lazy Reimu. I don't mind greedy Reimu, but in Wildhorn Hermit, it's exaggerated to a point of a plot point. I'm gonna switch, actually. I'm gonna switch to Charmander. It's just a bit exaggerated. I like Kassen, though. Wildhorn Hermit Reimu is what you go with if you want a Saturday morning cartoon plot. That sounds about right, yeah. I'm interested in Kassen because I don't know her motivation. I don't know what her end game is. I still haven't, like, figured that out. I'm pretty sure I know what it is. But I still don't know how it's going to play out, so I'm excited to see how that goes. That said, something I really like to see is the conversation between Suika and Kassen. And reading Wildhorn Hermit, I understand why so many people are like, she is so obviously an Oni, but nothing was, like, confirmed. And then when it was confirmed, everybody was like, oh, I am so surprised. The number of remaining Pokemon Like, one of the chapters was Reima was doing a Setsubun, which is where they throw beans to drive Oni away. And through Kasen's manipulation, I'm double teaming. Through Kasen's manipulation, she makes Reimu not throw beans and instead dedicate the event to cooking food-based items that have beans in them. And then Suika shows up and she starts stomping around and being like, "Oh, you gotta throw beans at me or I'm gonna get ya," and no one's reacting at all. And Reimu's like, "Oh shit, sorry Suika, I forgot to tell you we're not doing that this year." And Suika was legitimately heartbroken. She was so sad, I felt so bad for her. But then Kasen threw a snowball at her. Kasen threw a snowball at her, and then everybody started throwing snowballs instead of beans, and everything was good again. The thing about Wildhorn Hermit is I think it nailed the way Suika should be portrayed. Because Suika's a very intelligent character. She's not an idiot. She's quite smart. But she just does whatever the hell she wants. Suika does what Suika wants to do. That's it, nothing else. She's quite smart, but she's okay with just playing the fool because it's entertaining. It's fun for her. That's what Wildhorn Hermit portrays her as, and I like that a lot. I like that kind of character. I do wonder if there'll ever be a situation where she gets, actually serious, but I doubt it. Most Toho characters would be quite scary in a serious setting, but they tend not to be. Oh my god, look at this guy. Overdrive Riff Rock is a full body experience. She pretty much doesn't have a single bad bone in her. No, she's a good girl. Alright, so you have electric types and grass types. Electric and grass. So Charmander is the easy lead here because Charmander covers all of this. Geodude is a good lead here as well. And I don't think Slowpoke is the problem. Maybe Spinarak. I think Spinarak. I don't think Slowpoke's a good idea here because it's weak to all six of them. So we'll go with Spinarak. Spinarak will get a chance, but Charmander's definitely the lead. She does have a drinking problem. Well, she's allowed to. Also, I learned about Oh god, he actually used Sunkern. Oh, that Sunkern's invincible. It has the god HP. Alright, Jimmy, bring it on. She's an Oni, she can handle it. Yeah, pretty much. Oh, that's dead. That's super dead. Suika, not Suika. What do you call it? Kasen. Kasen has her own Oni, item. It's a magical drinking cup that heals anything on you. But if it heals you, the next day, it turns you very... It basically turns your behavior to that of an Oni. So everybody went a little bit rough the day after. Avoid Thunderwave, nice. Thank you, Demo, for gifting a sub. A double crit? Damn! Alright, good job, Charmander. Two crits. Hammered! Well, that was good. Nice hacks? Shut up! I deserve this, and you know it. Oh, it's Pichu. This is the last Pokemon. Alright, Pichu. A hot battle is unfolding. Thank you, Yo-Yo, for also gifting the sub. 136 to 37. What'll it do? Chat, I'm so sad. I'm so sad. So many emote slots available. All we need is that average. But that average is so hard to hit. I don't even need a crit to kill Pichu. It's Pichu! Chat, that guy used Sunkern and Pichu on the same team. Sunkern and Pichu on the same team. And he wasn't. He wasn't the first enemy. he was the fourth. Fade out. You can do that. You can't do that live, though. Alright, yeah, that was a clean sweep. Sure is challenging out here. Shut up. Shut up. Alright. Thank you, Major. For not gifting the sub, for actually subbing. That doesn't happen very often around here. Thank you, dude. And now you've started the train. Again. Enjoy your shitty emotes when you get them. Oh, look at this guy. Have you ever gone fishing? Isn't it addictive? Well, not in real life. I can't fight water types, chat. Thinking about what to do with channel points, you can give total factor whenever the channel points if you're interested. Well, I just do that if people ask. Because I like talking about it. I wouldn't charge people anything for that. Hoppip's the easy choice here for sure. Who else? Spinarak? Spinarak, not, maybe not. Definitely not Charmander, definitely not Geodude. Yeah, basically these three. Ditto's kind of not helpful. Hmm. Second scam train of the night. If people ask me questions about Toho, I don't mind answering. I really don't. The thing is, it allows me to learn, like, pretty much flex my knowledge, but at the same time, if there are things I don't know or I get wrong or I forget, I can get a refresher, which is nice. I like to be accurate with my information. I'm never gonna make anyone feel stupid or bad for asking a question that seems simple. That's not what you do. When people are interested in the things you're interested in. It's alright, Solar Beam doesn't weaken in power in Rain Dance, I don't think. Damn it. Oh shit! I'm alive though, bitch. I'm alright, okay. Fucking fisherman. What's your favorite species featured in Toho? Good question. I'm pretty sure I'm faster than it. Wait. Oh, chat, my Slowpoke has Sunny Day. My Slowpoke has Sunny Day. I should have left it Slowpoke. The Tengu are cool, but I don't think they're not as portrayed as much as they should be. I don't know what Hakutaku is, but they're interesting. Fairies? I like the fairies. Oh, fuck off. I need to get the Sunny Day up. The sunlight has turned hard. There we go. I never really thought of that, because there's not a lot of representation of, like, oh, fuck off. You doing this? There is a sudden downfall. God damn it. How's that? Ugh. Alright, well, here's a problem. I can't keep the weather up sunny. So I just have to hope I don't flinch. Amano Jaku. I get two of those. Two of those in the lore, and I flinched. Aw. God damn it. They all have Rain Dance. I guess, considering like, one of my favorite characters is an Oni, probably Onis. So, Hoppip's a bit of a problem here. Spinarak's not too good either. I'll go with Spinarak. I like the Onis a lot. I used to not care much for Yugi, but I've come around to her. But maybe that's just because she's always around the other Onis that I'm forced to see her anyway, so it makes sense to me. Only a good protagonist. Remy is said to be strong as an Oni. Remy herself also doesn't like Setsubun. She doesn't like beans. I missed the hype train. Oh no, whatever will I do? Yugi's looking 17.5. Oh yeah, she looks way better in the that outfit than her gym clothes, that's for sure. Wait, what? Quick Claw? You gotta be shitting me! Well, this isn't good. Uh-oh. The rain stopped. I have an idea, chat, but it's a little bit risky. I don't know if vampires qualify as a kind of Oni, but there seems to be some kind of combination of that. There's also another thing in the lore that apparently in like Toho 7.5, Patchouli has a lot. Patchouli has some kind of distrust in Oni, but it seems she doesn't explicitly know why. Oh, of course you have Icy Wind, you son of a bitch. I mean, what was I gonna do? Not go for Solar Beam? Fuck off, that's annoying. Alright. Damn it. I don't have an electric type for this, so I have to rely on Solar Beam more than anything. Things might have been different. Things might have been different if I had didn't lose to a Quick Claw. But yeah, Patchouli seems to have knowledge, get it, of Onis and like what they're like. She doesn't seem to explicitly know why. She just doesn't like them for some reason. So maybe there's some kind of relation to that with Remilia, since Remilia has the same aversions as an Oni does. I don't know. There's some speculation in there as to why she has. Why are their names so fucked up? Snoobask, Dratinao, Venenetti? Like, that's a horsey, you dummy. Alright, this time I'm gonna try this combination where I'm gonna lead with Slowpoke and make sure Sunny Day goes up. But only we're a class of devil. I don't know. It's to be honest with you, I really don't know why that's explained the way it is. We just refer to them as Oni. I know Oni can mean other things, and some people have gotten annoying about it. I don't fucking know, okay? They're referred to as Oni in the grand scheme of things, so I'm going to refer to the three of them as Oni. That's what it is. You can say it means whatever you want, but we can also say that other things mean whatever they want. Nobody cares. Some people get nitpicky for no reason. Why? What did I do to deserve that? There we go. There's only two vampires in the lore anyway. I wouldn't say Kogasa is vampiric in nature, that's for sure. But she herself, she's a zombie, right? She bites you. You turn into one. I guess, I don't really know how Remilia and Flandre's abilities work like that. Alright, thanks for the crit, Slowpoke. Good job. That's Yoshika, not Kogasa. Did I say Kogasa? Whoops. Also, chat, did you know that Kogasa's a blacksmith? And Kogasa made Reimu's needles? Her new needles? I find that kind of funny. She supplies Reimu with her new needles. Maybe that's why they're not as good. You're not supposed to make that public. Oops! Right? Gotta keep that a secret. That was the promise. And now I'm slandering her. Yeah, I'm a bad man. That was neat to see, though. That was neat to see. I hope this kills me, just so I can switch and get a free Solar Beam. Alright, well, I'm switching to Hoppip. Might as well. Going to Hoppip. Crit on me doesn't count as lore. Kurumi is she's a boss from Toho 4, I believe. She's the third boss. She's a vampire on the way to Yuko's, not Yuko, Yuka's place. I'm just pressing Solar Beam, dog. You can't stop me. Might have a Quick Claw. Don't know Kurumi. She's, yeah. She's an older one. It's not surprising that you wouldn't know much about the PC-98 characters, because they're really not talked about much, but they show up in fan games and such. And even then, there's very little on them that, like, there's only so much we know. We just kind of know what they look like, and what they, the little text they give us. Folks say Elise from 1 is a vampire because bat. Well, I don't know. There's not much to most of the PC-98s. No, there isn't. There really isn't. But they're still fascinating characters. Alright, that one went much better this time. Battles are fun, but so is fishing. Join me sometime. Bite, spam, and Squirtle, son of a bitch. Alright, I got my continue back at least, but it's not really gonna matter that much. Oops. Yeah! Move on, next video game. Sariel is very tall. She's an angel of death. She's cool, I want her to come back. Normal types, psychic types, bug types, psychic types. Fly slave. Chat, I'm pretty sure that, pretty sure Slowpoke can't learn fly. You know, just spitballing here. Just maybe, you know. I don't want Slowpoke to show up because I don't have anything to hit it with. I guess Hoppip. Slowpoke itself. Charmander's helpful here. We're going with that, chat. We're going with that. We're going with that. Sariel's very big. She's an angel of death. She has a cool theme. She looks cool. But we're never ever gonna know anything about her because Zun will never bring her back. So it's a battle you want, is it? Well, it's a battle you'll get. How about thee? I want a special drop. Oh, you poor fool. You absolute fucking fool. You have no idea what you have just wrought. Going underground. Spin! I'm coming back up with a vengeance. Unless you switch into a flying type like an asshole. Yeah! What's this? Hit. That is like some damage. That did pretty good damage. Not really, though. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. Made it tougher. Except for Mima, because Zun probably forgot about her. Poor Mima. Spin! Good. Good, 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 good. Oh, now you're surfing. You gave me +4 attack and you're surfing? Alright, now I just need to, break confusion here. You can do it, Slowpoke. Nice, well done. Dangerous move, it was the best option. I don't need Slowpoke for this fight. Slowpoke doesn't do much, but you might as, if you have the +4, why not risk it, right? Why not risk it? In this case, I can't do much. I can just press Psychic. There we go. We're good. High risk, high reward. That's what it is. I weighed the risk to the reward, and I decided it was better to go with that. Yeah, that won't do much damage. Thankfully, with that special drop, it means I'll be able to hit KO it even with the heal. So that's very lucky. Chat, I'd just like to point out that this is now the second Pokemon that my Slowpoke is faster than. Good. There it is. Down we go. Mima's just retired. That's all. Pretty sure Dig will kill this with plus four. So let's just do. Why am I faster than Sentret? Really? How? It's swaggering too. Retired means dead in JoJo terms. Shh. Shh. Her spirit ascended, okay? Shut up. Maybe that's why. Oh, chat. I figured it out. I figured it out, chat. The reason they say that heaven is too full for people is because. Okay, don't tell anyone. They put Mima up there, right? And Zun can't have anyone confirming that she's still around. So that's why they don't let anyone else in heaven. That's it, I figured it out. I've solved it. Does Swagger have negative priority? It shouldn't. It shouldn't. I don't know why. It doesn't have perfect accuracy, I know that, but it shouldn't have negative priority. The only moves that have negative priority are ones that, are the moves that, what's the word here? That alter the state of the battle, like Trick Room and, Trick Room and phasing moves, like Roar and Whirlwind and Dragon Tail and stuff like that. I have no idea how that Sentret is slower, I really don't. Oh, another Rocket Grump. What's with you? Doesn't Team Rocket terrify you? Hey, Demo. Or Ditto. Swagger has normal lack of priority. It's neither positive nor negative. No, it should have. It should only have 85 accuracy, unless back then it didn't. Also, that Smeargle has a blue tail, and that Ditto is called Speedman. Okay. I don't know what to do here. Fuck it, I'll just go with these three. Pokenza. Ah, yes. The legendary Pokenza. Bonica. What did it do? What was that? Takedown? I hope that wasn't Body Slam. Special drop? I'll win this. This is a 1v1 I can win. Headbutt? Oh, shit, really? Excuse me? I didn't even know you could learn that. Chad, I didn't even know that Jigglypuff could learn Solar Beam. Flannery is not really locked in the basement per se. She's in there, but it's not necessarily like, oh, you can just completely stop her. She just kind of accepted that. I don't know, it's hard to explain. Maybe she doesn't have interest in the world outside, but, you know, there are different ways to portray the character. Normal types can learn a lot of moves, yeah, but no one can help teach her or train her. Flan's a neat. Yeah, basically. Flan's a neat. She doesn't know how to interact with the outside world, so she just hangs out in the basement. She also doesn't know how to hold back, which is why she's so she's considerably more powerful than her sister in that sense. I mean, she's... I'm pretty sure Remilia and Flandre are... I'm pretty sure Flandre is still stronger than Remilia, but because Remilia knows such things like restraint, Flandre comes off as much stronger because, well, I pretty much answered the reason for that. Nice. Just wait till you get the cheating detective Satori. I'll get there eventually, don't you worry. I thoroughly enjoy reading the stuff. I've been doing it more often. I can win this. That's fine. Flandre also appeared in 16.5. Now, come on, 16.5. You know how that game works. Snubble. High Chop. The names are all kind of backwards. I'm fire punching it. Maybe I should have used Dig. Yeah, 16.5 is the fourth entry in the Aya style of games. I say style. I say style because it's not an Aya game, but it kind of is. It's closer to an Aya game than Impossible Spell Card is. Chat. This is problematic. Okay, I'm faster than it. I want to burn it. Nice. What's an Aya game? The Aya games are the one I was playing, I'm playing right now. There's Double Spoiler and Shoot the Bullet. They're the games, they're not called Aya games, so to speak, but I call them the Aya game. Oh, great. Well, this is what we're doing. So there's Shoot the Bullet, then there's Double Spoiler, then there's Impossible Spell Card, which isn't Aya, and then there's Violet Detector, which again isn't Aya, but it's much similar to that style of gameplay. I'm alive, bitch. You don't shoot, you just take pictures. But it's called Shoot the Bullet! It's called Shoot the Bullet! It went underground again. Wait, why are we doing this again? There is a camera item in Impossible Spell Card, I know that. God damn it! Come on, Charmander! Yeah, go for it! Down he goes. Ditto is a surprisingly annoying Pokemon to deal with. But when I have a Ditto on my team, I feel like I can't utilize it the same strengths. Except in Kaizo when I utilized it to kick the shit out of the extra trainer. There's the Glacier Badge. Ditto transformed into a Gengar and deserved to kill a Tyranitar. Absolutely deserve to do so. I forgot to save. Oh, well, that's fine. Won the last match anyway. The Juggler. These balls contain Voltorb. Juggling them is such a rush. Oh, he's an adrenaline junkie. All right, you have a strange combination of Pokemon, don't you? So you have water, steel. Okay, so I... I think this is what I want to do, chat. I'm leading with Slowpoke, and I'm going with Hoppip and Charmander. Let's rock it. Impossible Spell Card is actually possible, unlike most Ho-Oh games. Did you know you can beat Impossible Spell Card without using any of the cheat items? I have yet to see anyone do that, but I'm pretty sure you can. If I'm lucky, he has Solar Beam, and he eats the Psychic. Yeah! Yeah, my brain is massive. There's a big HP difference between the two combatants. It's possible, yeah, I'm pretty sure there's extra content if you do. No way. No way there's extra content. Have you seen Remilia's Nightmare Wheel? Holy shit! How do you beat that without cheat items? Has it ever asked what your favorite Toho game is? Going off official stuff? I don't know. I played quite a few of them now, that's for sure. Probably... This is gonna be a boring answer, but it's probably, 8, 7, and 6 in that order. I like 8 because it has a lot of my favorite characters and has some of my favorite themes. And it's probably one of the easier ones to get into. PCB is really good as well. And it has some quality life changes that were really needed. That were really, really needed from Toho 6. And Toho 6 is just a fun game with good music as well. Very, I would say it's nostalgic, but it's not like I really played much of it. Okay, it's gonna fire punch. It's gonna fire punch. At this point, Hoppip's probably dead anyway, so I'll just headbutt, go for some flinches and chip damage. Why not? Why not? I've never actually played any of the fighters aside from 7.5. But yeah, no, I think 8's a really good one to start with. And again, it's got some of my favorite characters in it, some of my favorite music. Although, Subterranean Animism also has some of my favorite music, and that game's hard as fucking balls. I don't mess with that one. EOSD's great, that's great music. It's just, it's missing some quality of life things that were introduced immediately after it, you know? Stuff like the enemy health bar being colored so you can see when spell card's coming, an indicator on the bottom of the screen where your opponent is, where the enemy is, and of course, no visible hurt box. The lack of a visible hurt box quite hurts. Oh, he has a quick claw, okay. It's okay, poison will take it out. This might hurt though. Those three tend to be like the most because they're classic. There's no gimmick forced into it, and they allow you to start with multiple lives, and they're good for playing for score. A lot of Toho games after that, from Mountain of Faith and onwards, they lock you to a certain amount of starting lives, and then they change the way you get lives and stuff, and they were kind of gimmicky. You can feel however you want to feel on these things. It's up to you to decide which games you like the most. You already know I don't like the UFO mechanic in Toho 12 at all. The life piece mechanic is pretty cool, but it's kind of, it's a bit rough in Subterranean, and it's better later on. But I think the way lives were done back in the early games was just fine. It was based on your point, certain point items, and just certain marks in the levels would give you certain parts of the levels would give you lives, so you could always kind of tell where you were gonna pick a life up. And if you were playing well, you were playing well, you had a lot of lives to spare. But in a game like 10 Desires, as easy as it is, it feels really hard to get lives. You feel kind of choked. They give you a negative score multiplier. Yeah, they also encourage you to play on higher difficulties for good scores. Alright. Yep, I'm gonna water gun it. Chat, who do you think was the best Pokemon on the team here? Was it Slowpoke or was it Charmander? No, kind of hard to say, to be honest with you. I won though. I like Mountain of Faith, but I don't like your shot powers linked to your bombs. Yeah, that's a weird one. I don't know if I don't think I mind it too much, but I also don't pay attention to it, and then I'm at like one power, and then I'm not getting through shit, and I'm just like, God damn it. Slowpoke, Slowpoke, Slowpoke! Hoppip did its job. Slowpoke did its job. Slowpoke did more than its job. Slowpoke was pretty much present in every fight. Geodude only showed up once. Got one kill. Ditto didn't show up at all. Spinarak showed up and did a job. So Spinarak gets some praise. And Charmander. Charmander did a lot too. Nice trophy. Challenge Cup Pokeball clear. Number of tries, 1. Wow, you're just gonna do me dirty like that? Alright chat, we got 1 trophy. Okay. Alright, what's next? What's next? So the way I think I wanted to break it up, chat, is there's 10 cups we have to do, right? But each gym leader castle match is only 1 trainer. So I think what I wanted to do is do like two cups and then 1 gym leader and then call it like that. Good night, Mayui. Babby cup should be neat. Oh god. All right. We only have to do it once. Same with Prime Cup. And then Poke Cup is the standard format. Challenge Cup 1's down. I think I'll do Poke Cup 1. I'll do Poke Cup 1. Just to get that the ball rolling on those. Alright, now we get to pick some Pokemon at least. Let's see what happens. Remoraid. Oh, good. There he is. Surf, Flamethrower, Thief, and... Why are you so good? Excuse me? Alright, sure. Alright, yeah, maybe that'll come in handy. Who knows? Spinarak. Oh. If Spinarak is the same moveset, I'm probably not gonna use it. Sludge Bomb, Leech Life, Attract, and Protect. Chat, should we count this? It's technically a different Spinarak, but it's still Spinarak. Should we count it and reroll, or should we not count it and just use it? Skip it, we already had it. I'm leaning on that myself, yeah. Has Attract and Protect. What scummery is this? Skip it. Alright. Pichu. Can I skip this on the grounds that I hate Pichu? Is that okay? Zap Cannon, Sleep Talk, Sweet Kiss, and Charm. Can I... Pidgey! Oh, no. This ain't looking too good. Wing Attack, Fly, Double Edge, and Protect. Hold on, give me that fucking berry. Give me that berry for recoil. I'll give Pichu the Ice Berry, because nothing freezes you in this fucking game anyway. Alright. Far-fetched. Fly is decent, but now I just got a better flying Pokemon. What number is Farfetch'd? Shit, dog, where is this Pokemon? I'm looking, but I don't see him. Oh, there he is. Skull Bash, Double Team, Sleep Talk, and Iron Tail. That's terrible. That's terrible. Articuno! Whoa! Whoa! Sky Attack, Bubble Beam, Fly, and Double Team. What the fuck do you mean, Bubble Beam? What do you mean, Bubble Beam? Huh? I don't even... There's not even Ice Beam on that! Pinsir. Ugh. Return, Mimic, Takedown, and Snore. This is the worst thing Can you effectively control bug Pokemon? His team is so much better than mine. He is a Cleffa. The fuck do I do about a Cleffa? Alright, Wooper Z. So my Articuno has God damn it. What is the point of any of this? Alright. Pidgey, Articuno, and Remoraid. Why can't I have Ice Beam? Why do I have Bubble Beam? Shit, I don't know, dog. Fly, I guess. Our move's weaker and stronger Pokemon is. It's randomized, so as long as there's, as long as they're required to have a minimum strong stab. But you are right, that is how it works in Pokemon Stadium. It is also balanced in a way that the lower on the evolution chain the Pokemon is, the better its IVs, or sorry, DVs and whatnot are. So they can at least try to stand up to better Pokemon, but sometimes it is all for moot. Sometimes you can't do anything about it. That didn't do shit. Let's go, Pidgey. We're gonna take out Air Shell. Insert a stupid amount of attack. Yeah, it does, but its only method of attack seems to be takedown and return. And I don't know if return will do much damage, because I don't know what the happiness value is on a rental. Crit. I asked for one thing, and one thing only. Shit. Wish I had Aerial Ace. Let's go for Double Edge. Coming at ya. Yeah. Yeah, Pidgey! Reverse. I got the reverse nice. What Pokemon will appear next? Oh, it's Lydian! Oh, your bitch ass is going down. You ain't ready for this heat. Bring it on, Nelson. I'm coming for you. Supersonic? You scum. You're scum. You're actually scum. That hit me? That's impossible. That's impossible. Ha. Ha ha. Ha. My Pidgey's a genius. My Pidgey is as smart as me. You can never hope to confuse my Pidgey. The sunlight has turned harsh. Alright, I don't know what you're doing here. Yeah, that's my Pidgey, alright. That's my Pidgey, alright, yep. Cool. Good job. They're both hanging tough. Why do you have that? Fuck off. Come on! Why? What else am I gonna do? Yo, I got a berry? I forgot I did that. You've used your entire moveset on me. It's better protected against physical attack. This is some shit. Crit. That wouldn't even killed it. I'm upset. The heated action continues. Chat, I'm wasting a turn. I'm wasting this turn. It assumed a protective pose. Supersonic. What, that? No, that didn't. What a waste of time. Sparks are flying from both competitors. I'm out of here. Fuck this. I'm using that sunny day to my advantage. I'm lighting this bitch on fire. Chat, do I really have to do 8 fights with this team? Do you know what happens if I can't win with Articuno? It was a critical hit, though. The sunlight has oh! Great. Bleh. Great. A level 9 Lugia with multi-scale can survive a level 100 Letty against Iron Fist Mach Punch. The white hot battle continues. That's concerning. You know that? Thief. Grab. Thief attack. Yes, it's a hit. Nice, thanks for the crit. No Letty! No! A level 9 Lugia. Andrew, that's cheating, though. His name is Digtent. Good name. Remoraid has good moves, at least, but it's Remoraid. Oh, no. Don't do that. No. It didn't do shit, but it can flinch me. That's the only reason Rock Slide's annoying. Because it flinches. Sun's down, Reflect gone. Reflect doesn't matter for this move anyway. You're probably dead. Yes. I seem to be good at landing consistent crits in a row. You notice that? That's like the third time that I have gotten 2 crits in a row. Red, yellow, blue. I like how I used Pidgey, Remoraid, and Articuno. These things happen. Mans didn't even know I was packing an Articuno in the back. He saw the Pidgey and Remoraid, and he was like, ah, oh, that's alright. He'll never know, chat. He'll never know. Alright, Swimmer Man. Aren't the ladies here lovely? Oh, you want a battle? Why does he have better Pokemon than me? His Staryu and Clefairy are one level higher than the rest of his Pokemon. That's cheating. What do I have here to fight this nonsense? Nothing really. I lose to electric types. What does Pinsir have? Takedown. A strong takedown, that's it. Farfetch has Iron Tail and Double Team. And Scalbash. Farfetch has some cheap shit. But he has two electric types, and my entire team loses to electric attacks. That's not good. AG, Remoraid, Articuno. Articuno is Double Team too. Shockwave doesn't exist yet, at least. You have a Bitterberry, you have a Mintberry, you have a Berry. I don't know. What did I pick? I didn't mean to pick Pidgey, actually. But Remoraid doesn't hit anything here very well. Well, some of them it does. But then it's stuck. But is Pidgey really the better? You know what? Fuck it. We'll do it. I am an Articuno. What are you?
It used the item it was holding.
Oh, got nothing. I have nothing, chat, so I'm using Double Team. Double team. Double team. I'm using double team. Chat, you want to know a fun fact? Did you know if you use thunder on an opponent who is flying, they can get hit? Did you know that? Same with gust. So that means if I press fly, all this double team is for nothing. So I have to use bubble beam or sky attack. I'm not better than this. I'm not better at this at all.
Oh, that missed too. The white hot battle continues. They prepare for battle.
I have to do this to win. Otherwise, I can't beat that thing.
Ah, it raised its evasiveness. There's the shot.
The fact that it has fucking thunder is something else. The meta of Sword and Shield is dominated by Teleport Clefable. Alright, now my evasion's maxed out, and I'm at one hit to death. This isn't even gonna kill it, that's the worst part.
The other one looks tired. There's the attack. It's not very effective.
Ah.
What will it do? That's a hit.
Ah, Articuno! Articuno! The best Pokemon in the world. Oh my. Double Edge coming your way. Yeah! Yeah, fists go down. I can't believe a Chinchou killed my Articuno. Why did it have to have Thunder as a stab move? I don't think I've gotten to use a Pokemon with that yet. I've only had Zap Cannon. Fuck this shit, I'm out. Never mind, you go first. That didn't do that much. I'm a Pidgey. I'm the strongest. Yeah. Yeah. I lose to anyone who uses electric types. Why are you using Endure? Are you expecting to die? I don't know what I did wrong. What did I do wrong? It just uses a move, it doesn't waste time. That didn't do any damage at all. I'm double edging. That might kill me, though. That'll definitely kill me. It's doing, like, 50-ish. What? I'm alive? Oh, now I'm dead. Crit. Suicide Pigeon. Damn it. Damn it. Why? Pidgey, why? Who's my last Pokemon again? I don't remember. I should have brought the Spinarak, you're right. That Spinarak. I should have taken the Spinarak. Oh, this is some fucking shit right here. Look at this. What am I supposed to do? Oh my god. You know Iron Tail's accuracy is 75? Oh. Catch my Iron Tail. Oh, what's next? Send out. I don't even know what you had. It's fucking drowsy. Alright, time to double team my way to victory. Or not. If I lose, I'm restarting. This team is trash. It's so bad. I will carry this team to victory for as long as possible, though. That Articuno, though, it can do its job. It just needs to not get hit by fucking thunders. Hypnosis. What are you trying here, dog? That can't hit me. I'm evaded. Drowse number one. What do I do? Skull Bash or Iron Tail? If I Iron Tail, I'm not gonna hit him. Skull Bash is two turns. It increased its evasiveness. What now? Oh, that missed too. A hot battle is unfolding. Not gonna jinx myself. Gee, it sure would be swell if I got hit by that hypnosis. Oh, I have sleep. Oh, fuck, you're right. I have sleep talk. If he hits me with that, I can still hit him. What the fuck? I didn't even consider that. I was like, well, if he hits me with that, it's over. Never mind. He's playing ball. I'm ready. You actually hit me. You gotta be shitting me. Ha! 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 I did it, chat. I forgot I had that berry. Well, so much for that. That berry was playing. Had to be. I just threw that berry on it because I didn't give a shit. I wasn't expecting anything to actually put me to sleep. Yeah. I think I can't roll Skull Bass because it's a two-turn move. Oh, well, that didn't have its max HP. That's pretty good. Oh, maybe don't! Maybe don't! No! No! Oh. Alright, yep.
A sharp attack.
Missed.
Oh, that's a miss.
Missed.
What now?
Missed.
Ooh.
You hit. What? Right. How? What the fuck? I have a plus six in evasion! How am I even asleep anyway? Oh, come on, man!
No, the move failed.
No! Yeah, that won't work, dipshit. Don't tell me Dream Eater has perfect accuracy. Oh, he's gonna put up another light screen. I'm gonna skull bash shit out of him. Put up your light screen. Put it up. Put him up, dog. Put him up. Yeah, that's what I thought. Idiot. I'm far-fetched. Alright, now you're catching one of these. I win.
The last Pokemon goes down.
I kind of wanted to lose. I kind of wanted to lose so I could pick better Pokemon. All I did was play myself. Okay, I'll be training the Tropical Seas. Then again, I don't have the travel budget. Poor man. Why am I still here? Oh, it sucked. As soon as the guy with the electric type shows up, I'm dead. She'll be coming around the mountain. Huh? Battle. Kate Mania. Highhorn. 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 Send out Rhyhorn. I think he'll send out Rhyhorn because it's level 53. Yep. There's that brain again, chat. My Jimmy Neutron-like brain. Is he switching? Tentacool, right?
Oh, it's Tentacool.
Is that a shiny? No.
The first move.
No.
It's not
the way that Pokemon Stadium worked is that nicknames made the Pokemon's palette change a bit. Some of them were reminiscent of shinies, but it wasn't the intended. It wasn't the intended method. Oh, I just killed myself.
What do we do? That's it. The white hot battle continues.
I'm gonna burn.
Sludge bomb away. Hammer where it hurts. Oh, it has no strength left.
Good.
What Pokemon will appear next?
Doesn't matter.
Okay. Oh, it's perfect. A hot battle is unfolding. It's building up power for its next attack. Aha! It's confused no more. What next? Hit! That was good. They're both hanging tough.
What are you doing?
The Pokemon is returning to its Pokeball. This Pokemon is rejoining the battle.
Oh my god. Oh!
What now? Ah, that didn't do much. What impact will this Pokemon switch have on the battle?
Nothing. It'll have no impact. What are you doing? What? Why?
What's this? That has no effect.
Alright. Alright, sure. Sure, 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 sure.
A furious attack. It's super
effective. Yeah. What? What?
There's the attack. Ah, that attack just bounced.
That didn't do shit, idiot. That's not good. No, please don't do that again. Stop! Barely. Don't put words in my mouth, announcer man. I'm losing. I'm losing the game! Hit an Iron Tail, come on. Yeah. 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 I don't even remember what you have. I don't even care what you have.
Oh, it's
Furret!
Now is the time to attack.
It's faster than me. It's faster than me. That better miss. That's just disrespectful. I just got killed by Slam. Slam's like one of the worst moves in the entire game. Alright, here's my goddamn Big Bird. Slam, come on. See, told you. Told you it sucked. Alright, here we go again, chat. We're gonna slowly increase our evasion because we're good players. We were dealt a good hand. You know what this is, chat? This is like playing blackjack and getting a 2 and a 3. But you're also given a can of black and red paint. So what my double teaming is I'm slowly painting my card so I have a blackjack. That's all I'm doing. We're turning that 1, we're turning that 2 into an ace, and we're turning that 3 into a king. You understand? And once we reach that, we have to play the game known as Evasion, which is also the forgery check. They keep missing, they're never the wiser. I walk out, I make bank. Bada bing, bada boom. That's how she work. How she go.
Ah, it raised its evasiveness. Sparks are flying from both competitors. There's the attack. A light hit.
It still hit me. I'm mostly preparing for the stupid Tentacool. The Tentacool after is gonna use Sludge Bomb on me. That sucks. You shouldn't rely on luck when it comes to Pokemon battles, just so you know. But I have no choice but to rely on such uncontrollable factors.
What now? Whoop, that missed.
The worst part about it is that my best moves are 2-turn moves as well. So I can't even dish out the move I need to do right away. Instead, I have to deal with Slam, 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 Shrek Super Slam. I really got hit by that 3 times.
There's the shot.
That's not even gonna kill, that's the worst part.
It's a fierce battle.
Am I gonna lose? Maybe it's for the best that I do.
What next? No, that didn't connect.
I'm flying! Bye. Articuno's not exactly strong, but I am a legendary.
Here comes a Pokemon switch.
What the fuck? Why?
The Pokeball opens to reveal its Pokemon. A furious attack! A savage hit! How will this Pokemon?
At least Bubble Beam will kill it from that range. I don't know why it did that. Hi. Yeah. Alright. I don't know why he did that. Maybe he threw the game because he wants me to win. Furret! Slam. Game over. Game over! I win! Regrettably. Regrettably, I'm the winner. At what cost? Wait, what? What are you doing? What?
The move didn't quite work.
Yeah, you can't snore when you're awake. Whatever. Chat, I won. I won, and I'm so ecstatic that I won. Why can't I fight things that are weak? That are weak to flying. I lost on purpose. See? See? He's... You know what? I'm actually tempted to believe him. I legitimately believe that he let me win. Son of a bitch. Pre-recorded stream. Who are you? Do you have electric types? Any battle can be won by applying logic. What? You want to test my hypothesis? He has a bunch of fucking normal types. Normal types and a Diglett. Why is this Porygon 2 and his Apom level 55? You ever think about how that's not fair? How maybe that's cheating? You ever think about how much of a cheater you are? You cheaty, cheat, cheat, cheater? Fuck, man, I don't know. He's got 2 Porygons. He's got Gone Poring and Gone 2 Poring. Yeah. Farfetched? I'm scared of Ditto, because if Ditto transforms into me, it steals my double teams. Whatever, I don't care. We're doing that. Intensifying? You have not been watching my match. Chat, I guarantee that if I was doing this strategy in real life, and Pokemon was real and I was doing this, I would be booed out of the stadium. Also, somehow I managed to get the Diglett lead, and that means that's 1 Pokemon down, so that's good. Goodbye, Digby. Yeah.
It went down as soon as the battle started.
Yeah. Digby.
Will this turn into
Clutch Box. Night Mad God. Oh, fuck. Just so you know, chat, important thing to realize here. If the AI has a level 55, they can't bring both of them. The level total limit is 155. So because he brought his level 55 Apom, he won't be able to have his level 55 Porygon 2 on the same team. And the reason I went for Flamethrower and not Surf is because I wanted a burn more than I wanted the stab, because this thing was always going to attack me first no matter what, and I'd rather weaken its damage output instead of double teams.
be the next Pokemon.
No matter what he sends in next.
Trainers bring their prize Pokemon to engage in wild battles here in Pokemon Stadium. Fierce and sometimes stealthy, Pokemon trainers often gather here in pursuit of victory.
What prompted that one, Mr. Narrator? Well, whatever.
Okay.
Let's go with Farfetch'd.
Oh, it's Farfetch'd! Farfetch'd!
I'm just gonna go for the Skull Bash. Why not? Strength.
What now?
It's gonna hurt.
That's it.
That's fine. Skull Bash will increase my defense.
It's building up power for its next attack.
This probably won't kill it though. Hope it switches. No, I'm just gonna keep using strength. Alright.
There's the attack. That was a cleansing blow.
I might be able to live one more of that because of the defense buff. Damn it. It didn't die. It didn't die! Which means it's gonna get a hit on Articuno. I lived. Come on, Iron Tail, do your job. Yeah! Finally! Some good luck, I think. Maybe? Alright, what's next? Porygon or Lickitung or Ditto. Hope it's Ditto.
Oh, it's
I didn't want to set up double teams against this in case Ditto came out, just so you know. That's why I decided not to do that.
What'll it do?
Yeah.
The hit lands right off.
Hey, damage is damage.
There,
that's good. Down. I didn't even know it could do that. I can miss. Damn. Farfetch'd just explodes. Alright. Lickitung versus Ice Bird. You're not ready for Super Chirno. But Super Chirno doesn't have Ice Beam. So maybe you are ready for it. This is the raunchiest Articuno I've ever seen in my life. It has Sky Attack, Fly, and Bubble Beam. Now that's raunchy. Did you see that? That motherfucker just double teamed. Do you know how bad it's gonna be if I don't hit this?
A sharp attack. Great hit.
Nice! I win. Wait. Oh, that's not good.
That settles this battle.
The word I'm looking for is heat. That ain't heat, Andrew. Bubble Beam Articuno is not heat. That's so flaccid. Yeah, sure. Go on doing things in your savage way. Man, fuck you. You press double team. I say as if I didn't get this far doing the same thing. It's the agency tech. Alright, what's next? A beauty. I'll show you how grown-ups battle. Water types. Water types and flying types. Helix. That Omastar is so green. Okay. You know what's funny? Is this is actually a fight that I can reasonably bring Pichu into. So I'm going to. Don't believe me? There it is. Articuno, of course. And I guess Farfetch'd. Or Remoraid. Pidgey or Farfetch'd, chat? Pidgey or Farfetch'd? 102, 104. Pidgey's faster? Farfetch'd just... my slowest Pokemon. Not counting... Oh my god, are you serious? Farfetch'd is my slowest? I thought Farfetch'd was decently fast. I didn't even know Pinsir was that fast. I mean, granted, that's not that spectacular a speed stat, but that's better than I expected. I guess Pidgey. No, Pidgey's not as strong as Farfetch'd is the problem. I'll go Farfetch'd. Yep. I thought Farfetch'd was fast! What the fuck? How? Why is it not fast? What else does it do? Why am I using Pichu? Why am I using Pichu? Fuck off, really? I'm dead. You gotta be shitting me! Who do I go with? Okay. Good job, Pichu! Well, if anyone had to face tank a Hyper Beam, I'm glad it was him. And here we go, chat. The most boring method of play possible. Go ahead, reflect. I don't care. You think three heads are better than one? Well, maybe. We'll see. Well, now, what about three Articunos? I don't like that I don't have... I don't even have... I don't have... go ahead. Go ahead. Make your sub.
It's still not going to attack.
Oh my god. All it has is Hyper Beam. Why? Are you shitting me? I'm gonna lose.
Ah, it can't move. It's still padding its stats.
Stop, please, stop.
A hot battle is unfolding.
You only have five of those, right? It's back up to full. How much did it take to make that sub? 35 HP. I need to do 35 with Bubble Beam to break it. Is that enough to break it? Is it enough to break it? It is. It's enough to break it.
The white hot battle continues. The commands are made. A furious attack. That takes some damage. Oh, and down it goes. Just one Pokemon remains.
All right.
Oh, it's Farfetch'd. This is the last Pokemon. Sparks are flying from both competitors. Ah, it can't move.
Good job, Pichu. Well, here we are once more.
Ah, it raised its evasiveness.
That was its last Hyper Beam, right? That was his last Hyper Beam? I think it was. Might have one more.
It's still not going to attack.
No, I'm not. I can't win if I attack. No! Why? It ran a- It can't attack me anymore, chat. It can't attack me.
It increased its evasiveness. They're both
All I can use is attract, reflect, and substitute. Stop. Please stop. Please stop doing that. My Farfetch knows what you did to its friends. It'll never fall for you. You harlot! Yeah, fuck off. Looks like hot dodries were in my area. Farfetch don't care though. It's just failing. Why is it failing? That's really weird. Why is it just failing like that? Is the game being merciful to me? Is that what's going on? I'm gonna press Skull Bash and get defense up, so that's what I'm gonna do. I wanna move like attract miss. Is there an attraction clause? Shouldn't be. I've done this before on my end. It just won't work, I don't know why. I didn't want that to be a crit, actually. I wanted to get as much defense increases from Skull Bash as possible, so I could at least resist things physically. Well, that sucks. It's the one time a crit is not helpful. Yeah. I have a feeling if she doesn't have Omastar with her, because she probably would have switched into Omastar to resist my Skull Bash. Farfetch only loves one thing, and that's the stick it holds. You must be joking. Nope. Automod catches those words because you know how the world works. More specifically, the state of Twitch. Cool. No! Okay. Forgot I had plus six. I might have forgotten that I had plus six evasion. Maybe just a bit. Hiya. Hit yourself. Ha! Idiot! Chat, if it hits itself again, I get the Skull Bash whatever comes in. Yeah, Farfetch'd. Ah, it lived. Fuck. Well, that was lucky. Makes up for the Tentacool that didn't. Alright, what's left? What's left? Alright, Psyduck, me and you. What do you got? Foresight? How does a move like Foresight miss? Nice. Stop doing that. Wait. Oh, no. That means my evasion's gone. Uh-oh. That's bad. Fuck off. What are you doing? Never mind. I did a chat. Who needs Articuno when you have Farfetch'd, am I right? Yeah. Alright. I win. Why did I win? How did I win? Farfetch'd and Pidgey have done more than Articuno. That is unbelievably true. Farfetch'd just cleaned up. I guess the way you do things is alright. No, it ain't. There are still three more matches, chat. And I still can't win if they bring electric types. There's a chance that if it's all for naught. But hey, that Pichu though, right? That Pichu? I'm busy, can we get started? Like, in a hurry? He's just fire types, yeah? Oh my god, this is terrible. Oh no, he has special, sad face, slow cow, cheese, mistriage, fake, and dour no. Uh-huh. I see. Surprisingly, Remoraid does very well here, except against slow cow. Yep, you guessed it, chat, the usual three. Special is quite the name. It's very true, though. Sneasel sucks in Gen 2 and Gen 3. It's a physical attacker, and both of its stabs are special-based. Good. Like, hustle, hustle. This is good. This will probably die to one surf. Alright, come on, Remoraid. Up and down. Is it enough? Nice!
Whoa, that was fast. It's down already.
Sneasel's main attacking move in Gen 2 and 3 is Shadow Ball. Now that's some sad right there. That's a sad voice. I mean, to be fair, the same thing can be said about Absol. But Sneasel had to do it for two generations. And then Gen 4, they're like, here... You know what the worst part is, too? Even in Gen 4, when they gave Sneasel an evolution... They didn't let it have Ice Punch, except for an egg move. That's shitty.
There it goes.
Yo, fake? Well, chat, isn't it nice to see that we're slowly getting through this one without incredible amounts of pain? He said he was in a hurry. I'm just hurrying along. Now I hope it's not Wobbuffet, because Wobbuffet has the potential to fuck everything up. No way, did I do it? The clean sweep? Special slash. Poor Cronon and Sharpedo. Yeah, they suffered from it too, you're right. Kingler suffered through it for three generations as well, but Kingler never got better. Some of those Pokemon got much better. Kingler was not one of them. Isn't it nice when we win one, chat? And for Alligator? Oh yeah, for Alligator too. For Alligator had passable special, at least. But he's definitely a physical attacker. You're right. Alright, chat. That fight... That fight took, like, 3 minutes. And every other fight before it took at least 10. Remoraid sweep. Burglar Jensen. Let's see a jab out of that one, fuckhead. Alright, we're moving on. Two more fights. Remy sweep. Kind of. Feraligatr unfortunately played second fiddle to Gyarados its whole life. Yeah, this guy probably has ice types. You know you can't move if you're frozen. Oh, thank god he doesn't have ice types. I would have been fucked. So he's got Houndour number one. Again, another situation where Remoraid does really well, except if Ampharos shows up. If Ampharos will kill me all over the place. Ampharos will murder me. Just don't send an Ampharos. Oh, good! High Horn's here! Pharos Am.
Pharos Am!
He's switching. He's switching too. That's okay, if he switches. He's switching into a Surf. Gloom is not what I was expecting. I don't mind High Horn being alive. I'd rather go for a Flamethrower here.
Not very effective. It used the item it was holding.
Yeah, no, I definitely want to stay in Flamethrower. I'm probably faster than Gloom. Yeah. This might work out in my favor. It might not. We won't know until it happens, though. This won't kill it. But it can kill itself with Confusion. Nice. Fantastic situation to be in. That's good. That's really good. That takes care of an issue. A potential issue. I don't know what it was capable of. Here we are. I can't switch, chat. Bubble Beam is fine to kill Rhyhorn, so I don't need Remoraid in this situation. But I think... I don't know what I want to do here. Let's go for Confusion Shenanigans. Remoraid is faster than that, at least. I need to go for some cheese. Decent damage. I could go for burn or I can go for stab. I'd rather go for stab because it's slower than all my Pokemon for sure, so I'll always be able to get a hit in. I'm just worried about Farfetch'd. Since Farfetch'd strongest move is a two-turn attack and Iron Tail's a little bit risky. And it has Thunderbolt too. Yeah, it's dead. Super dead. Yep. It having Thunderbolt is the worst possible outcome.
Oh, it's Farfetch'd. Will this Pokemon avenge the honor of its fallen comrade?
Iron Tail won't kill it. I have to go for Skull Bash and hope for Confusion hit. I have to go for Skull Bash. Oh boy!
Building up power for its next attack.
Okay, it choked. I hope. Thunderbolt can't hit a Pokemon using Fly, no. It can't. This is good, this is good. That's fine. It's still confused for four turns? Oh, okay, alright, sure. I kinda thought Confusion was over at that point. I was ready to accept what was coming, but I'll take it. Swagger paid out, thankfully. Rhyhorn time. Okay, well I can do Iron Tails and I'll have Bubble Beam in backup. So this is good. Good hit. Sandstorm. Alright, it's fine. Generation 2 Sandstorm does not increase Rock type's special defense. That only started happening in Gen 4, I think. I think Generation 4 is when that started happening. Might have Horn Drill. Yeah, but I'm still faster than it, so Bubble Beam will go off. Even if it has Rock Slide, which will murder Articuno, I'll be faster than it. I'm okay, though. Sandstorm did 12% this generation. I guess because that's all it could do was residual damage, huh? I'm surprised that worked out. Chat, that's the second Rhyhorn we've killed with Farfetch'd Iron Tail. Even though in the exact same situation, I was like, oh, Remoraid can kill that instantly. And then it switches and then Remoraid doesn't do anything to it. And I'm like, alright, I have Bubble Beam in the back. But then Bubble Beam doesn't need to be used at all because Farfetch'd is apparently a god. Good job, Farfetch'd. One more battle, chat. Somehow we're on the last fight. I don't know how we made it at this point. It's been slow, it's been painful, but we're here. A psychic. I perceived a jolt. Oh no, please don't mean electric types. Oh no, he's got Electrode. That's game over. Lost Race, Speed Man, Squirt Tiny, Gassed Age, and Drowsy. This is a problem. Those two Pokemon are a massive problem. I'm gonna go with Farfetch'd as the lead, and then Remoraid and backup, because Remoraid isn't that helpful here, but Remoraid handles Jinx really well in the off chance it brings that one. The real issue is Electrode. I hope that Electrode has something that's inaccurate. That's all I can say. Otherwise, other four Pokemon are perfectly okay to deal with. It's just those two in the side. What's nice, though, is that of these six Pokemon, chat, it can only bring either a combination of... it can only bring a combination of 52, 52, 51 at max. So that means if we see Drowsy and Totodile, it means only Squirtle and Ghastly is allowed. If we see Ghastly and Squirtle, it means only one... Well, obviously, it means only one of those ones are there. But they're only allowed to have two level 52s and one level 51 here. So that means as long as we can confirm who the level 52s are, we'll be okay. I really hope it's not Electrode. Jinx is manageable, but Electrode is probably a lost cause. I can't do much to that thing, especially if it has Thunderbolt. It's faster than everything by far, and if it has a guaranteed hit on me, it's super effective on everything. But enough about that, let's go. Pinsir doesn't really have any good moves, that's the problem. Squirtle's fun. Let's go for early setups. I don't know what Squirtle has.
It raised its evasiveness.
Hydro Pump. That's inaccurate to begin with.
What does the other side do?
Good, good.
Oh, that's a miss.
Good, 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 good.
A hot battle is unfolding.
Thankfully, the only move in this game that is guaranteed to hit is Swift, so I don't have to worry about moves like that, which normally don't matter at all, but in a situation like this, it will matter. I have to risk max double teams for ultimate effectiveness. I can't just go half-heartedly. I need the evasion to win, because I am a cheesy boy. It's a nice mix of the trainer battle theme. That's four Hydro Pumps. Four Hydro Pumps. One more and I'm in the clear on that one at least. Alright, it's five double teams. Good start. That's Bedu. Quick Claw. Quick Claw. Good. That's the end of that, so we won't have to worry about Hydro Pump anymore. But I don't know what else it has. As long as it's not too bad, I guess. Then we can start going for Skull Bashes. There we go. Toxic. Oh, please no. Please don't. Please don't. Okay. Toxic is a massive problem for this strategy. Yeah, Quick Claw. I hate Quick Claw sometimes. Quick Claw is one of the best items you could use, though. But when they have it, it's annoying. Because as you can see, sometimes that happens. At least I'll get a turn one Skull Bash here because of that. Good hit. That's a 2-hit KO. Oh shit, I'm dead! Well, I wasn't expecting that. Fuck, dude, what do I do about that?
We bring you this battle from the fully packed Pokemon Stadium. Who will emerge triumphant from this intense battle? Next Pokemon is ready.
Can't dodge counter.
Oh, it's Articuno. They're both hanging tough.
Okay, I need to move. This needs to kill it, because I can't afford to double team setup in front of a Toxicking Squirtle bubble. Here's the problem, chat. If that doesn't kill it, guess what happens? I get hit by counter. The anti-scum Squirtle. Yeah. Turns out Squirtle was the scariest thing. I'm dead. Yep. Why is this Squirtle so fucking strong? And it got the quick claw.
What'll it do? The hit lands right off.
Did 4 damage. I don't know why it's not toxicking. I don't wanna risk it though. Well, that Squirtle is the worst thing in the game. So we'll probably see a restart here. It won't matter if he sends an Electrode anyway. Electrode decides the battle from the start. Yep. It has Zap Cannon, there's a chance. I set a chance. I set a chance. It sure showed me that. Hope it explodes. That would be one way to go about it. Soundproof doesn't exist yet. Not that it matters. It'll go for Zap Cannons anyway. So we can just try to dodge that. And he brought the Totodile too. That fucking counter Squirtle, dude. The counter Squirtle? Unbelievable. Alright, well, I saved here, so we'll continue. We got 2 continues though, so we don't have to immediately restart. We can start from here legitimately. Alright, what do you got? I don't want to see the Squirtle anymore. I don't want to see the Squirtle. Maybe Articuno is the better lead. Bubble Beam will be a death of a thousand cuts, but it might be a better opportunity to work with. This is assuming he leads with Squirtle again. Hypnosis Spammer. I don't have to worry about Quick Claw on this one at least. Pretty sure there's an item clause that you can't have the same item on your Pokemon as another one, so we just need to avoid Hypnosis, or it'll Double Edge instead. That's weird. That's okay. I can afford to take some of those, but I'd much rather not take any at all. Hmm. One Quick Claw, one Instant Claw. Always go first. Secret item. You get it by collecting 99 Quick Claws. And then you bring him to Kurt. And then Kurt's like, these are Quick Claws. Let me show you my magic. And then he'll perform a magical dance. And then he'll fuse them together and it creates the Instant Claw. And it's a Quick Claw that always works. But you need to beat the Elite Four like 50 times and complete the Pokedex twice. Trust me. I don't have any sources to back up that information. You just have to trust me. You also have to get blessed by Celebi. Yeah, you also need the GS ball. You also need the GS ball.
What's this? Oh, that is too. Both battlers still look fresh and ready for more.
You remember those playground rumors, chat? I mean, I wasn't really old enough for them, but people who are older than me probably know that the only thing you really talked about on the playground with Pokemon was that it was the different bullshit that you heard or read or made up yourself. And you always made it to be, you always made the requirements to get them so incredibly difficult, but not exactly impossible. So nobody would ever be able to fact check you. And you know how those people would be. You could sit there in front of them and do exactly what they told you needed to do and have it not work, and then they'll still pull another excuse out of their ass. Watch as this Drowsy has counter, because fuck me. Just keeps pressing Double Edge. Ow. They always have a reason. You never want to be that guy. You had to call a towing company to finally move the truck. Oh yeah. That killed it? Wow. I'm legitimately impressed that killed it. Alright, send in Trogdor! Of course, it's fucking Electrode.
The white hot battle continues.
Zap cannon.
There's the shot.
I was gonna say, what are the odds of zap cannon hitting me, chat? Please tell me.
What now?
That did fucking 20. I'm pretty sure Sky Attack's stronger. 50%. I mean, with my evasions, dumb bum. The instant claw below 50%. Man, chat, I hate you sometimes. Think you're so funny. You think you're so clever. You think you're so smart. Watch this does more than Bubble Beam. Huh? That did more. Fuck off. Why are you holding a berry? How do you even eat it? How do you even hold it? You got no arms. 16.6. That's not bad. I mean, I would go with those odds.
Building up power for its next attack. They're both hanging tough.
Max evasion, you basically divide accuracy by 3. Oh.
And this hit finally puts it down. What Pokemon will appear next?
Give me a second to think here, jackass.
They're ready to go. Oh, it's Marfet.
Hey, chat. Did you know that was a crit, too?
Sparks are flying from both competitors.
He's out of zap cannons, though. Please don't let that be effective against me.
That attack just bounced off.
Didn't do much. No, I'd rather he'd have zap cannons.
The white hot battle continues.
Oh, it has Swift! Oh! Nice! Can't even cheese it. What? This Electrode is just specially engineered to fuck with my team. Unbelievable. This man really was psychic. It actually is psychic. I'm gonna win though. What are you doing? Where are you going? Why? Who'd you switch into? Ghastly. You're a bitch.
What now? Whoops, that attack's no good. How will this newly switched out Pokemon fare?
No! I don't even know what that does!
No, that didn't connect.
This guy is so smart. He might even be smarter than me. Stop doing that. I don't know what that does.
Oh my, missed again.
Ghastly's huge.
A sharp attack. Yes, it's a hit.
Oh, fuck yeah.
They're both hanging tough.
Stop that.
It
worries me.
Oh, that missed too.
Not even a crit. Duck is good. Ghastly sucks. There's no physical defense. Nice job, Duck. Go! Big spook. Sigh. You brought it, dude.
There's only one Pokemon left to come up.
Might confuse me. Psywave does not confuse. Psywave is a move that only does, I don't know how its damage calculation is, to be honest with you. It just does damage. Swift. Stop that, you fool. I'm so glad that the Electrode had Zap Cannon and not Thunderbolt. We'll deal damage from 1 HP to 1.5 the user's level. Oh, so it's like set damage, but not set damage. It's a random interval of set damage. That's weird. Fuck off.
Building up power for its next attack.
Not good.
Are both Pokemon running out of steam?
Shut up. 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 Miss. Miss. Well, I mean, it can't miss, but No, I have a defense buff, so I'm fine. I also have Remoraid fully healthy in the back. Don't worry, I know how to play Pokemon. Also, hindsight's a bitch. You can sit there all day telling me what I should have done, but at the end of the day, you can only say that because I've already made my choice. It doesn't make you look smarter. I never predicted I would lose. Is it impossible to see one's own fate? Yeah, you dumbass. Give me my badge and get the fuck out of here. I win. Remoraid. Now, Remoraid did good. Remoraid cleaned up a few matches. Pidgey did alright. Pidgey came in handy, I guess. Fuck Pichu. Farfetch, the MVP. Articuno, somehow worse than Pidgey. Pinsir, it's like he wasn't even here. Yo. That's a cool looking trophy. It's a very shiny N. Never used Pinsir. Nope, didn't need him. He sucked. Didn't even have submission. If he had submission, I would have considered it, but he only had normal type moves. Alright, chat. We're not done yet, though. We're not done yet. I'm gonna make a save state, and now we're gonna do one gym leader, because there's only one match. So, we're gonna go them in ascending order. So, we're gonna do Pewter. So, here's what we're gonna do. So, we're gonna do two cups, a gym leader, right? So, next I'll do two cups. And then Misty, so that, well, maybe not exactly like that, because there's 8 gyms and 10 cups, right? So I'm trying to break it into an even amount, but maybe I'll end up doing two of these. I don't know, I'll figure it out. I'm just trying to evenly distribute it in a way that, so when I get to the end, I can cram it all into one final episode, you know? And I think just having a stretch of gym leaders is the best way to go about that. Did I say asshat? Oh. Pretty sure it didn't say that last time. But I did re-randomize it. Wonder if anyone else changed. Let's see. Vohio. Yeah, well, alright. Those are changed back to normal. Price is not, is right. Claire is not Tsundere. Vohio. Chuck and Grunt. High IQ in heaven. Oh, I know high IQ. Snowflake's still there. I'm a boy still there. Nothing for Faulkner. What about these fuckers up here? We won't be able to see Cheater's name, but it's probably still Cheater. We got Will, Admist, and Tryhard, and Karen. Alright, cool. So we have Asshat, Erica, Surge, Pyro, Sabrina, Beat Misty, Janine, not Koga, and Brock. So let's do Brock. Night ditto. Alright. Let's see what the team is. Magneton. It's a good Pokemon, maybe. What do you Magneton got? Thunderbolt, Reflect, Return, and Bide. That's pretty good, actually. Ditch Confusion. Grumble. Okay. Have to redo the Elite Four again to see Lance's name. He's still a cheater, no matter what. No matter what, he'll always be a cheater. Grumble has Hyper Beam, Zap Cannon, Detect, and Charm. You know, for when you just want to go fucking apeshit, I guess. Pidgey has turned into Pidgeot. My Pidgey has evolved. Double-edged toxic sand attack and hyper beam. That's not the worst thing in the world, admittedly. Rhydon. Ooh. Earthquake, Bubble Beam, Tail Whip, and Payday? Okay, Payday. Vileplume. Where are you? Sludge Bomb, Petal Dance, Giga Drain, and Attract. That's a really good moveset, actually. And Poliwag. Poliwag. Hyper Beam could come in handy. Poliwag is Hydro Pump, Ice Beam, Waterfall, and Psy Wave. That's not terrible, surprisingly. To be honest with you, I think these are actually surprisingly solid Pokemon. Even the Poliwag, as a meme as it might be. So yeah, it's just Brock, though. Have you ever seen the durability of Rock Pokemon? Where's the rock type? Who's the hidden Pokemon? Air Jolt. So he has Nidoqueen, Yenma. He's got Meganium again. Fuck's sakes. This Meganium is everywhere. Alright, so let's see. Rhydon cleans up on two Pokemon. And it can resist Tufty pretty well. Vileplume does decently against the other one. Crobat is too much of an issue, but actually, Magneton's really good here as well, just not against a Queen. Pidgeot's not very helpful on anyone here. And Grumble can Hyper Beam and it does really fucking large amounts of damage. And Charm as well. Maybe Grumble's not a bad choice here. Let me think about this, chat. I think my best bet is... It really depends on what he brings. Meganium loses the Vileplume, but Meganium pretty much destroys these two. Well, maybe not so much destroys, but they can't handle it very well. Grumble's really good for just hitting something really fucking hard and having Charm to lower attack. I want Rhydon because it takes care of Jolteon with no issues. Pidgeot's not that helpful. Poliwag has moves, but nothing to really specifically deal with these Pokemon in question. It's fast, but I don't think it's good enough. I don't think it's faster than a Crobat, which is a massive problem. It's the one Pokemon I'd want it for. Ice Beam has decent coverage on Meganium. I'm thinking, chat. I'm really thinking here. Magneton does well against two Pokemon, and Rhydon can't hit Crobat or Yenma, so I feel like I need Magneton there with Rhydon. But then the question comes from who is the best choice otherwise? Magneton can't do anything to Nidoqueen, though. Maybe... I'm thinking Magneton, Rhydon, and Vileplume are the best choice. I'm just trying to figure out who I want to lead with. Because the problem here is the lead can mean everything. Because each of these Pokemon I'm going to bring has a good matchup against something, but not a terrible matchup on something else. I'm going to start with Vileplume. Yes, Vileplume. Because if something comes out that Vileplume can't handle, I can switch into Rhydon to tank it. I like that. We'll go with that. So these are revamped stadiums from the Pokemon Stadium 1 for the Kanto leaders, which are really cool. Good theme, too. Vileplume's matchup? Mega. Air Jolt leading off. So this situation? This is a situation where I switch into Rhydon. Because it's probably going to go for something. It might not even go for Thunderbolt, but it will probably go for something. Might have double kick, but I doubt it would use it there. Sand attack. I'm gonna earthquake because I'm probably gonna switch anyway. Once this is over and dealt with, I won't need Rhydon anymore. Nice eyeball. But if he switches, he has a flying type. He has a flying type. He brought one of them. Who did he bring, though? Just had to be sure. Crobat? Yanma. If I had a rock move, though. And Yanma has absolutely nothing to deal with Magneton. So now Magneton's coming in for sure. Even if it switches back into Jolteon, I'll be able to do some damage on it. And again, I can easily switch back into Rhydon and just not have to deal with it. This might take a couple turns to get correct, but I know what's going to happen. And never mind. It's now locked. It's now locked into Solar Beam, which is not going to hurt. I didn't even know Yanma could learn Solar Beam. Now you have to take a Thunderbolt from Magneton. Yanma's dead. It's one down. Down she goes. Ugh, that hurts. I like how exaggerated Brock's window is. It's fantastic. Angel, yeah. So, yeah. We're gonna do the same thing. He'll probably sand attack again. We'll see. Rhydon looks so cool. It's just a shame it's not a good Pokemon. Yeah, Thunder. So that means if it switches again, that's Crobat. If it doesn't switch, that's game. That's game. That means it doesn't have Meganium either. So it probably brought Nidoqueen. It's either Nidoqueen or the other one, which I don't remember. I can't remember who the other one was, but it's not Crobat because he didn't switch into it. If I had to guess, it's not Meganium either because he also didn't switch into it there. It was Wigglytuff. I'll go for an Earthquake. I'm Sand Attack, but it's not like... Well, that could suck. Rhydon's pretty good in Gen 1 and 2. You're right. It's better Golem. It's just... It's a very counter-pick-based Pokemon. In Gen 1, you cannot fight Rhydon with any Electric-type. It just shits on it. Can't do anything about it. But there are so many Pokemon that Rhydon cannot stand up to. Rhydon single-handedly stops Zapdos from doing anything. Absolutely shits on it. Just like that. Eviolite Rhydon is better than... is even better Golem. Yeah, Rhydon has better stats. He also looks cooler and has a better ability. I think. I don't remember. I just know that both of them pretty much did the same thing. How could anyone break through my rock-hard defense, he said, with Wigglytuff, Yanma, and Jolteon. Rhydon Golem are the reasons Zapdos didn't dominate Gen 1. Pretty much, yeah. Stop that, motherfucker. But then even in Gen 2, where Raikou is one of the second best Pokemon in the game, which is crazy to think about, that both Zapdos, the top 3 OU metagame was Curslax, so Snorlax, Raikou, and then Zapdos. And it's crazy to think that the two of the top 3 Pokemon in Generation 2 were Hardwalled. Maybe not even Hardwalled because Hidden Power existed at that point, but they were still pretty well checked by Pokemon like Rhydon. But now there were so many more Pokemon that could handle Rhydon and Golem. Okay. I think that's a good place to stop there. Just under 2.5 hours. We got 2 stadiums done, and we beat Brock. I am happy with that amount of progress. And you know what the best part is, chat? I didn't even have to rely on a save state. I made them just in case. But in the end, I didn't need them. So let me double save just in case. I'm just making sure. I'm just a little bit afraid that I'm gonna fuck something up, you know, and it's not gonna save properly. Just had to be careful with that. Challenge cup and poke cup. Yep, we're good. Awesome. Good stuff. I'm happy with that. It's a good day. But that's gonna be the end. I think what I'll do, chat, so what I did last week was I did, the game I did on Monday, I did on Thursday, so I'm gonna do the same thing here, so I'll do, tomorrow will be more Moemon, or not Moemon, Toemon. Wednesday will be Aya Day, Aya, and then Thursday will be more of this, and then Friday will be back to Toemon, and then Saturday will be Saturday, so I have the plan, chat, I have the plan. It's all in there, which means something's gonna go wrong to stop it, but it's all in there. But for now, we'll just stop it here. That's fine. Awesome. Yep, so, yeah, I'll see you tomorrow with Toemon and Mario Golf. Thanks for watching, guys. It was just a good stream, you know? It was a good stream. I enjoyed Tohoe Live a lot, and despite some of the issues that definitely arose in that one, I'd say we had an all-around feel-good time. I'm really, really happy with that. It was great. It was good. It was a good stream. It was a really good stream. But yeah, I'm gonna get out of here. Good night, everyone. I'll see you tomorrow.